Kareem, sincerity is the essence of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. It's the essence of ibadah. It's the essence of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this creation. It has profound meaning to a slave when he is worshipping Allah on his own. It has profound meaning for a ruler. It has profound meaning for a father, for a mother, for anyone doing any sort of work. Sincerity is the essence of why our deed should be done. It is to be done for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And what will demonstrate this to you is the fact that there's a hadith of Rasulullah reported, or an athar actually reported in Sunnah Tirmidhi, that says that one of the tabi'een says, listen to this narration, he said, I met 30 of the Sahaba of the Prophet and of them I met the Ashar Mubashirin, the 10 that were promised Jannah.
Allahu Akbar.
And all of the 30 Sahaba, including the Ashar Mubashirin, were all afraid that they were munafiqeen.
SubhanAllah.
Right? And that is sincerity. Sincerity is to be afraid that your deeds will not be accepted. Sincerity is to be afraid that you actually might be on the wrong path. Sincerity is to constantly check your heart. So constantly check your intention. Constantly check why you're doing this. Are you doing this, the salah, so that you can, you know, show it off to people? Are you doing it for your mom or dad? Are you doing it for your wife? Or are you doing it for your husband? Are you building this masjid so you can be known amongst the people as a donor? Or are you doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the God, the unseen God that we worship?
How does one balance the fact that there is an element of sincerity and hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our actions?
Very difficult. I mean, this is the whole balance of life. Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, he said, كُلُّ عَمَلٍ عَمِلْتُهُ أَمَامَ النَّاسِ فَلَا أَحْسِبُهَا شَيْئًا. Every single deed I've done in front of mankind, I do not consider it to be anything. So the way you balance it, from my understanding, from what I've seen our scholars do, is that they do a deed, but they do not consider any of the deeds that they have done to be acceptable to Allah, because their hearts are not always going to be 100% pure. Mm-hmm. Plus Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the amazing, the great God, the perfect God, as-salam, right? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a result, are our deeds, as a deficient human being, are we able to offer a perfect deed to this perfect God? Very difficult, if not impossible. And that's why the scholars of Islam never used to consider any of the deeds that they did to be of perfect ikhlas. In fact, it was reported in the biography of a scholar of Islam by the name of Ibrahim al-Dustawai, a great scholar of hadith. Al-Dhahabi rahimahullah reports in Sir Alam al-Nubula, he says, قال Ibrahim al-Dustawai, وَاللَّهِ لَا أَسْتَطِعْ أَنْ أَقُولَ إِنِّي طَلَبْتُ عِلْمَ الْحَدِيثِ يَوْمًا قَتْلِ وَجْهِ اللَّهِ. He said, I cannot affirm in my heart that I definitely sought the knowledge of hadith even for a single day for the sake of Allah. And Al-Dhahabi says, right after his statement, he says, وَاللَّهِ وَلَا أَنَا. Al-Dhahabi says, even I cannot say that. And that is why Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say, he said, Tuba, meaning the gardens of paradise before that person who Allah has accepted even one of his steps on this earth that he made for the sake of Allah. And we have the examples of a man who entered Jannah because of a branch of a tree that he moved.
Yes.
I mean, how many people are there that actually move branches of trees? I mean, I remember that hadith, and I moved a lot of branches of trees. Am I going to be from those people that enter Jannah? Or how many prostitutes are there that are not only merciful to animals, but their children and whoever else? But we know of one prostitute that entered into Jannah in the authentic hadith because of a dog that was thirsty, and she went down the well and she got some water for the dog. So what happened? Why would they accept it? So Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says, how many are the prostitutes of this dunya who are also kind to people, but Allah will never accept it? And how many are the people who have moved twigs on branches from paths? Allah would not accept it. Why did Allah accept it?